Hi there, this is Virendra Dhir. My whole purpose of life is to be happy by sharing all the beautiful words, thoughts, wisdom which the poets, saints, sages, the philosophers, the prophets and the great masters of the success principles have narrated to us. I just enjoy it, sharing with you, trying to stimulate your intelligence to the perception of the truth that you are only responsible for yourself. Whatever novel thought and ideas I am sharing with you, if you really believe in them, trust them and practice in them, your life will change for all time to come. So that is the very purpose of life. You will be successful. You will have love, fame, fortune. Your fate and destiny will be at your command because your thought controls your act, your act, your habits, habits, your character, and character, your destiny, beloved friends. So in that context, let's think novel thoughts, great thoughts, and we are bound to be prosperous in life. That is the whole secret of success, to think purity, honesty, integrity, peace, love, caring, sharing, giving, and seeing the beautiful nature unfolding itself in all directions with peace, tranquility, serenity, and trying to sense from the nature the beautiful path of going extra mile, always giving everything what the nature has got. And it has sumptuous and abundance. It is never going to end in life. So the aim of my purpose of this particular moment is to make you happy. So the first thing is that be close to nature. Nature is pure. It is not complex. It is full of energy. It is enthusiastic. It is inspiring. Nature is perfect. It never tempers, it never deviates. It follows the universal law strictly. So if you want to be really happy in life, you must try to be a triumphant in your principles. Never deviate from your principles, which is based on truth, justice, peace, love and non-violence. And being wise, you know that our souls are on a pilgrimage on this planet Earth. So every moment is precious, buzz at every time, moment. And even your money, energy, everything else. So the first lesson is to be close to nature and learn from nature. Second is to avoid the company of the fools, the ignorant, the indolent, the thoughtless. They are the people who are the source of eternal pain. They will really try to ruin your life because their thoughts, act, behavior is more sharper than the scorpion. They are more poisonous than the most venomous snake on this earth. So if you want to be very happy in life, just get rid of the company of the fools and try to be in the company of the wisest people, the great people who really are sensible, who are on guard, who are vigilant, who are awakened, who are enlightened. Seek therefore the company of the sage, who is steadfast, learned, wise, devoted and noble. Follow the example of such a good and wise being. As the moon follows the path of the stars, that will really bring you really happiness. One of the Hindi poems is, Ram Bulava Bhejya Diya Kavira Roye, Jo Sukh Sadhu Sant Me O Baikunth Na Hoy. This is Hindi. The meaning is, everyone has to die one day, and when one of the great saints, Kabir, was to die, because God commanded and demanded that he should have come back to heaven, then he really begged his pardon and told, the pleasure he is enjoying the company of the wisest people on planet Earth is not even available in heaven. So that is the supreme importance of being in the company of the wisest people. One who frequents fools is bound to suffer long. The company of fools is as painful as that of enemies. To live in the company of sages is to share the happiness of one who lives among his kinsmen, beloved friends. Always seek the company of the best, the wise, the enlightened, awakened. It is good to contemplate the noble ones. To live near them is an endless happiness. One could be always happy by avoiding the sight of fools. Beware of fools. They can ruin your life. Beloved friends, nothing better idea than that I can share with you. Having tasted the sweetness of solitude and the supreme peace, a man is liberated from suffering and evil, for he partakes of the sweetness of devotion to the truth. Remember, if you have a positive mental attitude and you have a sound physical health, and that is the perennial source of your peace, happiness, joys, love, fame and fortune. Health is the greatest acquisition. Contentment the greatest treasure. A faithful friend is the best companion, and Nirvana the supreme happiness. That is a quote from Dhammapada. Nirvana means salvation, freedom from the sorrows and suffering of the cycles of life, beloved friends. So if you are a wise man, you should have very limited aspirations in life and kill all your unwanted desires, and then you will be enjoying really happiness. Hunger is the worst malady. Existence is the worst calamity. One who has understood this reality is that salvation is really the supreme object of any wise person, to really always be awakened, enlightened, with limited wants, desires, ambitions, aspirations, but only few which are very stimulating to self and to the millions. There is no greater fire than lust, remember it. A person who is always hankering after loves and fishes, lust, and always sheltering negative mental attitude, thoughts are always anger, hatred, jealousy, cynicism, envy, he is bound to suffer, because he will be living alive on the funeral pyre. So therefore, brave friends, there is no greater fire than lust, no greater misfortune than hatred. There is no greater misery than existence. No bliss greater than the supreme peace. Peace, peace, peace. Peace at all cost. You must be prepared to pay the price of peace. Then you will be really enjoying a life which will be poised, composed, a self-disciplined, balanced life, where there is only calmness, your power, and righteousness of your thought is really your mastery, beloved friends. So that is, I want to share with you, to enlighten you, and to stimulate your intelligence, to activate your genius sleeping in the bark of your soul. He does but sleep, wake him. You can do it, because this is necessary for you to live in peace, harmony and tranquility. Victory in dangers and enmity, remember it. If you are hurting somebody, injuring somebody, that is going to create more enmity. And one who is vanquished lives in distress. A man of peace lives only in gladness, disdaining both victory and defeat. Never try to win over others. Never try to be a conqueror. Try to be friends of everyone. By loving everyone, as Ashoka the Great did, he was a monster who wanted to conquer everything else. But ultimately he realized that the path of peace and prosperity for all is the real purpose of every mankind. And he dedicated his entire life for serving mankind by embracing Buddhism. Happy indeed are one who own nothing. We shall feed upon delight like the radiant gods, beloved friends. I want nothing but peace. I want nothing but wisdom. I want nothing but a heart which is beating always to serve the millions of people. I want nothing but the lever of love. That is the supreme wisdom, beloved friends. All the earthly possessions and everything around it can never give you peace of mind, but your wisdom, your controlled and balanced mind, wanting only what you want. Among those who are full of greed, happy are we to live without greed. Among the greedy, let us live free from greed. Among those who suffer, happy are we to live with our wisdom, free from all suffering, sorrows and grief, because we think before we speak, we think before we act. And only after due deliberations and contemplation, we really act, which endures none, which is fragrant and pleasant and beneficial to the entire society and to the mankind. Among those who suffer, happy are we to live with dedication, commitment and passion for the attainment of our definite purpose in life, aligned with the mastermind people, going extra mile with tremendous belief and faith in our own destiny, because we are the master of our fate and we are the captain of our soul, because we control our thought. That is the beauty, beloved friends. But be careful. Never injure others. Never hate others. Because hate will generate more hate. Only remedy is meditation of love. Love to your worst enemy. Love to everyone who has injured you and harmed you and hurt you in life. You will be always getting what you are giving. Giving and receiving. Equal opposite reaction to your every action. So what you give, that only you will get. Forgive them. They are ignorant. They do not know what they are doing. That's why they hate. Hate never. Love always. Care always. Give always. That is the supreme wisdom, beloved friends. So remember it. Among those who hate, happy are we to live without hatred. Among men who hate, let us live free from hatred, beloved friends. That is real my message to all my friends. Happy is he who possesses nothing. He will partake of the delight of the radiant gods, who has no sense of possession, who can make use of things when they come to them, knowing that they are not theirs, that they belong to the supreme infinite intelligence, and who, for the same reason, does not regret when things leave him, separates from him. He finds it quite natural that the Lord who gave him these things should take them away from him any time. For it is the sense of the ownership that makes you cling to things, makes you their slave. Otherwise one could live in constant joy and in ceaseless moment of peace, serenity, tranquility and eternal peace, beloved friends. Delight means to live in truth, to live in communion with the eternity, with the true life, the light that never fails. Delight means to be free. Free with the true freedom, the freedom of the constant, invariable union with the divine will. Gods are those who are tuned to the light, who live in the power and the knowledge. That is what the most enlightened one means. He does not mean the gods of religion. They are beings who have the divine nature, who may live in human bodies, but free from ignorance and falsehood. That is only my solemn request, beloved friends. Try to understand the purpose of life, the theme of living life. Think, think, think. Only thinking wise thoughts can really make you happy. You should not seek happiness outside of yourself. Rather, happiness is within yourself. There is a true happiness within yourself. External things can affect you much, because external things has no control. You have no control over external things. You have absolute control on yourself. So the external possessions may come and go, but your internal wisdom will be everlasting with you. You will see that a lot of people are enjoying blessedness without being rich, and much more people, they are in wretchedness with all the money and everything surrounding them. So be wise. Your internal decoration of your soul is your wisdom, your awakening, your perception of the truth. But I tell you, the better half who is wise and intelligent, she can be the best, or he can be the best spouse. So there is nothing to leave everything, but to get everything, which is the best people around you, men or women, the best children, the best citizen, the best friends, everything which is best is pure, is truthful, is poised, steadfast, and that is the source of peace, happiness, origin, because they are really very, very inspiring, motivating, stimulating, the very grassroot of all happiness, peace, joy. And then, beloved friends, remember the Rudyard Kipling words, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you will be really the happiest man, my friend. Once you are awake, you are enlightened, you are a thinking human being, always meditating upon love, joy, serenity, and always praying God to give you the wisdom and the courage to get rid of all the negative mental attitude. That is impurity, all negative elements. Meditate on pity, forgive those who are fools, still love them. And I love you. I love you very much. No doubt about it. Because love is life. Happiness is really the breed. And never forget those success poem of Ralph Waldo Emerson. True success is to laugh often and much, to win the respect of the intelligent people, to earn the appreciation of the honest critic, to endure the betrayals of the false friend, to appreciate beauty and find the best in everyone, to leave the world a bit better, either by a healthy child, or redeemed social conditions, or a patch of garden, and to know at least one life has breathed easy, has lived in happiness and laughter, that you have lived, my friend. Buddha lived it, Christ lived it, Confucius lived it, and so have lived millions. Now let's join that queue, seeking awakening, wisdom, enlightenment, and you become what you think about. If your mind dwells on pure thoughts, greatness, success, blessedness, the universe will support you, and everything will be at your command and possession. Avoid thinking which is dangerous to you and inimical to the whole surroundings and to the world. May God bless you. You are serene, you are calm, you are happy, and I love you and thank you.